My name is Justin Taraska, and you're in my lab at the National Institutes of Health in Bethesda, Maryland. My lab is a basic sciences lab, and we essentially study the fundamental processes of how cells work in the human body. We use microscopy to actually image the structure of cells and how they function when they're alive. We do that by essentially watching cells work in real time with light microscopy and with electron microscopy. Well, I actually grew up in Florida, and I grew up in a very sort of lush natural environment, lots of swamps and lakes and rivers. Over time, as I went through school, I just became more and more interested in sort of the fundamental workings of how nature and how life works, how cells work, how animals function. I actually did a summer research internship, where it was the first time I actually was in a lab where I could see how science really works. And it was that process of going through a summer internship and doing real research where I could see that experiments produced data that I could study, that I could learn something new, that I could contribute to the scientific dialogue, really made me realize that that's something I wanted to do. It's some path that I wanted to take. And currently my lab studies the biophysics of how cells function. Well, cells are essentially the fundamental building block of all life. Everything that is alive is essentially a cell. And humans are essentially made up of billions of cells. And sort of, if you can understand the fundamental workings of a cell, you can understand sort of the fundamental nature of how organisms like humans are sort of built and function. When you get scared, like if a giant dog jumps out at you from behind a bush, or if a bear is chasing you, a gland that sits on top of your kidney actually releases a burst of chemicals into your body, and that gland is called the adrenal gland, and those chemicals are called adrenaline. And that's what essentially produces that fight or flight syndrome that everyone's used to. You know, your pupils dilate, you get flushed, you get very, very strong, you can pick up cars. And that response is due to cells inside your adrenal gland releasing chemicals into your blood. And that process is actually common in your brain. It's how neurons in your brain talk to each other. It's how after you eat, your pancreas releases insulin. It's how you control your sugar levels in your blood. And my lab studies really the basic mechanism of how cells control that process of releasing chemical, and then once they've released chemical, to bring chemicals back in. And so what we do is we actually watch that process happen in living cells. And the way we do that is by essentially creating fluorescent versions of proteins, so proteins that glow. And we actually use a jellyfish protein that can glow green or red or blue. And we use a microscope called a fluorescence microscope to actually watch those individual fluorescent proteins behaving in a living cell. This is a cell from your adrenal gland, and this cell is being stimulated to release adrenaline. And each one of these little fireworks, each one of these little explosions on the screen is actually a single vesicle that's releasing adrenaline outside the cell. It's essentially the way that the cell communicates with the body. And what we're doing here is actually imaging this process of watching individual vesicles that are only 500 nanometers in diameter actually fusing with the membrane and releasing that chemical outside the body. If you could understand these basic principles, you can begin to think about how you would fix problems that might arise in these processes. People who have diabetes, people who have neurological disorders, people who have stress, have increased levels of catecholamines in their blood. So if you can understand how the basic mechanism works, you can begin to understand how you might fix problems that would arise in diseases that create problems for people. And really, the ability to bring in labs and groups from lots of different institutions makes our research much better, and it brings in new ideas and new methods and new techniques. And that's one of the reasons I like science, is the collaborative, really group nature of how science gets done today.
And what kind of cells are these?
These are actually bone carcinoma cells, so they're cultured bone cancer cells. Mm-hmm. And this is cavioli labeled on this side, and on this side it's clathrin, and we're trying to see if cavioli are actually linked to clathrin, and it looks like they are, at least from this data.
In the cell type?
Yeah. And actually, it doesn't matter what they're grown on, if they're grown on collagen or on polylysine, it looks to be the same. But wherever we see endocytic sites for clathrin, we seem to see endocytic sites for cavioli. Yeah. I really like the process of discovery. I like being able to watch something occurring really for the first time, to actually look at a cell and be able to understand the fundamental workings of something so basic to life. And so I get very excited in the lab when we see something new, something that no one has ever seen before. And those are just wonderful moments of discovery where everyone's excited. Work in a lab, see if you like it. Like, do experiments, you know, go find a lab to work in. And I think that if you do that, you will really see that working in a lab is one of the most wonderful experiences you can have. It's collaborative, it's dynamic, it's creative, you're really developing new ideas, you're finding your own path, and you're contributing new knowledge to the world, and there's really nothing better than that. Thank you.